back pain in a 74-year-old female. I want to talk about this case because this is so typical. This is typical for a lot of people that come into my chiropractic office. A lot of this, of course, is avoidable. I talk about avoidable circumstances a lot on this show and on my videos, things that you can do to make sure you don't get lower back pain and you take care of your discs, take care of your joints and so forth. But here's what happened in this woman. Now, she's been a patient of mine for many years and she's had flare-ups of neck trouble and lower back trouble. She was well for a year, no problems at all. Maybe mistake number one is definitely she did not return for self-pay maintenance care. So she does well for a year. Then she told me the history. This is over a month ago. She said, I'm driving along in my car and I started to feel some groin pain. Didn't think much of it. Within a week, it ended up being severe lower back pain all the way down her leg. Okay, so then she comes in to see me and she's pretty crippled. Sleep is interrupted. She can't do much. Getting in and out of the car was terrible. That was a chore. One of her main passions is she couldn't get comfortable in church. She had to sit in back in the church in some fluffy chair and couldn't participate, which was just devastating to her because she goes to church every day and participates in all the different activities that are going on and helping others. So she was very devastated about that. And of course, coming into spring, couldn't do anything around the house and so on and so forth. She's already on ibuprofen twice a day, comes into me, and she rates her pain on a 0 to 10 scale, 10. Okay, so she comes to see me, and the first week I see her 3 times, and her pain gets knocked down to a 7 over 10. So it's not quite as severe, and it is getting better. Unfortunately, she steps off of a stair, jams her foot a little bit, shoots the pain back up to a 9 over 10. On week 2, I see her 4 times. I'm working on her lower back. Just keep in mind, I did not do any manual chiropractic adjusting on her. What I was doing was drop table work, chiropractic instrument work, low-level laser therapy, cold laser, and soft tissue work, but no manual chiropractic work. At the end of week 2, we had her pain back down to a 6 over 10 and less leg pain. Finally, after week 2, she was able to sit in church and participate and do all the things in church, so she was really happy about that. Halfway through week 2, when the pain was really bad again, she told me this. She said, oh my gosh, Dr. Fuller, I don't know if this pain is ever going to go away, right? Here she is a couple of weeks of pain. I don't know if this is ever going to go away. This is really terrible. Now, oftentimes I have to talk people off the cliff. I knew her circumstance. I did my evaluation. I did my orthopedic neurological checks. I knew that she didn't have any bowel bladder issues. I knew that she did not have direct nerve compression from a herniated disc and causing the leg pain. So I knew that she was not a case that needed to be referred to an orthopedist or a neurosurgeon or anything like that. So I knew we had it under control. And plus, she was a patient of mine already. So I had to basically talk her down. I said, you need to give this a little bit more time. It is getting a little bit better. And sure enough, at the end of week 2, we had her pain down to a 6 over 10 and she started participating. She was also sleeping better and her ibuprofen went from twice a day to once a day. Starting on week 3, I saw her 3 times a week. And by the end of week 3, we had her pain down to about a 4 over 10. By the end of week 4, this is how significant it was. Last weekend, she was able to work 2 hours in the yard, raking and shoveling. She was able to do all of her church activities as well, and she told me she started spring cleaning. Her leg pain is now completely gone, and as of today's visit, her pain is a 0. She has no pain whatsoever, and you know the deal when your back is really hurting you. She had to kind of back into the car slowly, and then she had to climb out of the car slowly as well. For 2 weeks prior, her husband had to drive her to my office because she was fearful to drive because her pain was so bad. Then she got to a situation 2 weeks later where she could not only drive herself, but she was getting out of that pain-free. That is a pretty typical case. Here's the kicker. Now remember, she's 74 years old. So she has church friends and other friends, and they knew how bad she was, and she said, oh, I'm going to Dr. Fuller, my chiropractor. Her friends, she said, several of my friends told me, what are you going for to him for? He's not helping. Now, of course, they're saying this after week number 1. He's not helping. Why are you going to the chiropractor? You're wasting your time. Really? Are we like back in the 1920s here or something? So what was interesting is they only gave the chiropractic a week to help. Now remember that these are the same friends that she's had 2 and 3 and 5 years ago when I've had worked with her with other neck and back pain flare-ups, which were also pretty severe, and they saw her come out of those in a relatively short period of time, usually only a couple of weeks. Sure enough, 4 weeks in, her problem is completely erased again. And I asked her the question, so what do your friends say now? And she just laughs and they just say that they're really surprised seeing me back at the gym again, doing all of my gym workouts, back at church and doing everything else. So another great case of a 74-year-old female with devastating pain completely knocking her down and with 4 weeks of chiropractic care is back to full function. I'm Dr. Scott Fuller. Please join me again.